A little. So we will have only one day this year, as you may know, but I can promise you that it's going to be an amazing day, because you'll learn a lot of things, discover a lot our last tools, and of course you will be able to ask all your questions, and I'm sure you have a lot of. So we are here for you, we are there to share our love for Mozilla and for Floss with you. This year, there's a kind of topic that will pervade that day, that is Mozilla for everybody. Mozilla is truly existing for everybody, if you're technical or not, like me, I'm not technical at all. So you will see, and we will show you, that everybody can reach Mozilla. That's why we've decided to introduce that day with something very important for us, which is that we deeply believe in the education as part of our role. So, to begin this amazing day, let's listen to Eduardo and Flor. But before, just a word about Ashishur, who was supposed to do that talk with Eduardo. Ashishur is one of our contributors in Bangladesh, and unfortunately, he didn't receive his visa. So just please have a thought for Ashishur, because we would have him with us today. So first, we have Flor. Flor is contributing to Mozilla from a long time.
10 years.
10 years. She is one of the creators of the French community. She is a Mozilla rep now, and one of the leaders of WooMoz. And she is also a webmaker ambassador. Well, maybe it's due to the fact that she has two lovely children. She is already teaching them what Floss is and how to code.
Yeah, of course.
And then you will listen to Eduardo. Eduardo is also a Mozilla rep. He is the founding member of the Mozilla Paraguay community and is part of Mozilla Hispano. He is a software engineer and working across Paraguay and surrounding countries to give lectures on free software made him become very comfortable with speaking in public. So you will discover it. They will present WebMaker and MozEdu, which Eduardo is doing a lot in his country. This is a fantastic adventure, and I'm sure you will love to discover it. So please welcome Eduardo and Flor.
Okay, so I'm going to present you WebMaker, Mozilla WebMaker. So first thing, why WebMaker? Why did Mozilla bother to make WebMaker? Yeah. Well, you know, the first thing that we really want the public, general people, to know that the web is not a TV. Perhaps that's what big firms want to turn it into a TV, but we do not want. So we believe that everyone can be a WebMaker when they are presented with simple and reliable tools. And that's what WebMaker is. And WebMaker is about learning by making. You know, I think that most of you in this room, or perhaps a few of you, are coders. And we know that you learn code by reading books and so, but you can also learn code by looking code written by other people. How did they do this? Oh yes, it looks really, it looks nice. I should do that. One of the mission of Mozilla is build the internet the world needs. And if I ask you what is the internet the world needs, but probably you will answer that it needs an open internet. Okay, but what does it really mean, open? It means that it should be knowable, that we should know the web. Of course, it should be interoperable, because we are using internet on computers, on tablets, on phones, sometimes on TV, or a lot of devices, and we should have the same experiences on every device, okay? And it should be, the internet should be ours. We should make it ours. So how could we do this? Well, for making the internet knowable, we should know more about the internet, okay? We should do more, okay? And probably the most important part is do better. Okay, I think in this room, probably we all know what it means to do this, but it's important that non-geek people know about this. So this is why we build Webmaker, because everybody should be able to make something on the internet. And how are we going to bring this? Okay, Webmaker, what is it, Webmaker? It's web-based, there's nothing to install. Okay, it's basically a website. So you can access it from everywhere, from every computer connected to the internet, which runs Windows or Linux or macOS, okay? It's compatible with all modern browsers. So you don't have to tell people, okay, you must install this on your computer, or you should use only this browser because it's only compatible. People can use Webmaker with everything, okay? And it's only login with a Mozilla persona. So basically, a simple email address is needed, and to save and share your projects. Okay, I won't talk to you about Mozilla Persona because there's a talk at 1 p.m. in the staff room about Mozilla Persona, and you will learn everything you need on this. Okay, so the Webmaker tools. First, there's Symbol, an HTML editor. You can see there's a code and there's a preview of the web page. Okay, I'm sure you all know what HTML editor is. I know that you use your preferred HTML editor, be it VI or something else. Okay, but that's for normal people, average people. So they can just see whatever they change in this part of the screen, it's immediately visible in the preview. So you just change the link to this picture, it's in this part, and you can see it. You just change bit by bit, a little bit, something, and you immediately see the changing. The point is that HTML5, CSS3 compliant, it's good code. So it's like you begin to code, you change one bit, you see what it makes, and that's we call learning by making. Okay, that's pure HTML code. There's also a Popcorn Maker, that's all about video. Okay, that's video making. You have three parts. You have a preview part, like in Timbal. You have timelines, layers, and events. And element properties. So it's a bit of WYSIWYG, and you can make a video by make your own video clip by taking videos from YouTube, Vimeo, or music from SoundCloud, and remix everything with pictures from any website, of course, or your own computer. Maps from Google Maps, Bubble, pop-ups, Wikipedia pages can be integrated in the video. And there's also the X-ray goggles. If I can just perhaps switch to app. So you see, I activated the X-ray goggles on this page. So you can see as I move the pointer, that there's a colored overlay on every element of the HTML code. And okay, I click, I hope I have a... Not sure if I have enough Wi-Fi for this, but that's not... You would see the code of the element. You can change this and publish it. Okay, I know you could tell me, okay, I can do this using the web dev tools of Firefox. Of course, we can do this, but I'm not sure everyone using Mozilla Firefox knows the dev tools and would use this without being afraid. Okay, so that's a simple tool. Okay, it doesn't work. I'm sorry, which? Okay, so you could see the code here. Okay, so remix is a keyword of this. You have to keep in mind that WebMaker tools are made for the public audience, for people who are not developers, who are not geeks, but made for school kids, for pupils, for students, or for adults that just want to learn a bit of code or just make some cool things on the internet without having, for example, to learn too much about coding or HTML. And of course, WebMaker provides hosting. That means that your makes, your projects are saved and available on the WebMaker servers. So you don't have to bother about finding a hosting service, and you can just save the URL and send them to friends and share on any social networks. So the point is, you will hear people tell you, I'd like to make something that looks like that, pointing you to a web page or a video. So you just have to tell them, okay, this project in WebMaker, okay, you like it, you want to do something like that. Okay, just remix it, change whatever you want, and it will look like that. Okay, so that's what I already said, learning by making. And you can start by remixing an existing project or start from scratch, whatever you want. And to introduce Eduardo's speech, WebMaker is an education tool. WebMaker is now localized in 12 languages. And we think it's important that it's localized in as many languages as we can, because, for example, kids, they don't speak English. Not every kid around the world speaks English. They need these tools in their own languages. And the teaching kits also, because if the interface is in their own language, but the teaching kits are in English, it's not so nice. Okay. If you have questions on this part, please ask them at the end of Eduardo's speech. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. I have some technical problems, but I will speak without slide now. Then the Mozedu I talk about the Mozedu project. This project born into Mozilla Hispano some 2 years ago, and is basically this project is about to learn the children's and adolescents or adults to correctly use in the internet the dangers in the internet, etc. and to conscientiate and involucrate the people before to use WebMaker. And then our events is in some colleges, some college principal in schools, and the principal questions is for the children's to how to make the code and the internet, and particularly our preoccupation is the privacy principally in, for example, the children that use Facebook and some have a bullying to prepare the children for adapt him to not be a victim. I forget some words, and then if were my presentations, I can't show the image for our events in Paraguay, and 3 months ago was our first event in Brazil. I don't know. So my slate doesn't work. See, but thank you. Have any questions for Mosedu or WebMaker?
Maybe you have questions about their experiences, because both of them are really working on education through Mosedu, through WebMaker. And really, it's unfortunate for Eduardo not having his slides, because it's a deeply and truly experience that he's knowing in his country, and what he's doing is just astonishing. So I'm sorry for you not seeing that, but I really deeply encourage you to see them after the slot if you have some questions, because they have a lot of things to bring you and to teach you around education in code. Do you have questions? A little. So we will have only one day this year, as you may know, but I can promise you that it's going to be an amazing day, because you'll learn a lot of things, discover a lot our last tools, and of course you will be able to ask all your questions, and I'm sure you have a lot of. So we are here for you. We are there to share our love for Mozilla and for Floss with you. This year, there's a kind of topic that will pervade that day, that is Mozilla for everybody. Mozilla is truly existing for everybody, if you're technical or not, like me. I'm not technical at all. So you will see, and we will show you, that everybody can reach Mozilla. That's why we've decided to introduce that day with something very important for us, which is that we deeply believe in the education as part of our role. So, to begin this amazing day, let's listen to Eduardo and Flor. But before, just a word about Ashishur, who was supposed to do that talk with Eduardo. Ashishur is one of our contributors in Bangladesh, and unfortunately, he didn't receive his visa. So, just please have a thought for Ashishur, because we would have him with us today. So first, we have Flor. Flor is contributing to Mozilla from a long time.
10 years.
10 years. She is one of the creators of the French community. She is a Mozilla reps now and one of the leaders of WooMoz. And she is also a webmaker ambassador. Well, maybe it's due to the fact that she has two lovely children. She is already teaching them what Floss is and how to code.
Yeah, of course.
And then you will listen to Eduardo. Eduardo is also a Mozilla reps. He is the founding member of the Mozilla Paraguay community and is part of Mozilla Hispano. He is a software engineer and working across Paraguay and surrounding countries to give lectures on free software made him become very comfortable with speaking in public. So you will discover it. They will present Webmaker and Moz Edu, which Eduardo is doing a lot in his country. This is a fantastic adventure, and I'm sure you will love to discover it. So please welcome Eduardo and Flor.
Okay, so I'm going to present you Webmaker, Mozilla Webmaker. So first thing, why Webmaker? Why did Mozilla bother to make Webmaker? Yeah. Well, you know, the first thing that we really want the public, general people, to know that the web is not a TV. Perhaps that's what big firms want to turn it into a TV, but we do not want. So we believe that everyone can be a webmaker when they are presented with simple and reliable tools. And that's what Webmaker is. And Webmaker is about learning by making. You know, I think that most of you in this room, or perhaps a few of you, are coders. And we know that you learn code by reading books and so, but you can also learn code by looking code written by other people. How did they do this? Oh yes, it looks really, it looks nice. I should do that. One of the mission of Mozilla is build the internet the world needs. And if I ask you what is the internet the world needs, but probably you will answer that. It needs an open internet. Okay, but what does it really mean, open? It means that it should be knowable, that we should know the web. Of course, it should be interoperable, because we are using internet on computers, on tablets, on phones, sometimes on TV, or a lot of devices, and we should have the same experiences on every device, okay? And it should be, the internet should be ours. We should make it ours. So how could we do this? Well, for making the internet knowable, we should know more about the internet, okay? We should do more, okay? And probably the most important part is do better. Okay, I think in this room probably we all know what it means to do this, but it's important that non-geek people know about this. So this is why we build Webmaker, because everybody should be able to make something on the internet. And how are we going to bring this? Okay, Webmaker, what is it, Webmaker? It's web-based, there's nothing to install. Okay, it's basically a website. So you can access it from everywhere, from every computer connected to the internet, which runs Windows or Linux or macOS, okay? So compatible with all modern browsers. So you don't have to tell people, okay, you must install this on your computer, or you should use only this browser because it's only compatible. People can use Webmaker with everything. Okay, and it's only login with a Mozilla persona. So basically, a simple email address is needed, and to save and share your projects. Okay, for I won't talk to you about Mozilla Persona because it's, there's a talk at 1 p.m. in this dev room about Mozilla Persona, and you will learn everything you need on this. Okay, so the WebMaker tools. First, there's Symbol, an HTML editor. You can see there's a code and there's a preview of the web page. Okay, I'm sure you all know what HTML editor is. I know that you use your preferred HTML editor, be it VI or something else. Okay, but that's for normal people, average people. So they can just see whatever they change in this part of the screen, it's immediately visible in the preview. So you just change the link to this picture, it's in this part, and you can see it. You just change bit by bit, a little bit, something, and you immediately see the changing. The point is that HTML5, CSS3 compliant, it's good code. So it's like you begin to code, you change one bit, you see what it makes, and that's what we call learning by making. Okay, that's pure HTML code. There's also a popcorn maker that's all about video. Okay, that's video making. You have three parts. You have a preview part like in Timbal. You have timelines, layers, and events. And element properties. So it's a bit of WYSIWYG, and you can make a video by make your own video clip by taking videos from YouTube, Vimeo, or music from SoundCloud, and remix everything with pictures from any website, of course, or your own computer. Maps from Google Maps, Bubble, pop-ups, Wikipedia pages can be integrated in the video. And there's also the X-ray goggles. If I can just perhaps switch to... So you see, I activated the X-ray goggles on this page. So you can see as I move the pointer, there's a colored overlay on every element of the HTML code. And okay, I click, I hope I have a... Not sure if I have enough Wi-Fi for this, but that's not. You would see the code of the element. You can change this and publish it. Okay, I know you could tell me, okay, I can do this using the web dev tools of Firefox. Of course, we can do this, but I'm not sure everyone using Mozilla Firefox knows the dev tools and would use this without being afraid. Okay, so that's a simple tool. Okay, it doesn't work. I'm sorry. Which? Okay, so you could see the code here. Okay, so remix is a keyword of this. You have to keep in mind that WebMaker tools are made for the public audience, for people who are not developers, who are not geeks, that made for school kids, for pupils, for students, or for adults that just want to learn a bit of code or just make some cool things on the internet without having for example, to learn too much about coding or HTML. And of course, WebMaker provides hosting. That means that your makes, your projects are saved and available on the WebMaker servers. So you don't have to bother about finding a hosting service, and you can just save the URL and send them to friends and share on any social networks. So the point is, you will hear people tell you, I'd like to make something that looks like that, pointing you to a web page or a video. So you just have to tell them, okay, this project in WebMaker, okay, you like it, you want to do something like that, okay, just remix it, change whatever you want, and it will look like that. Okay, so that's what I already said, learning by making. And you can start by remixing an existing project or start from scratch, whatever you want. And to introduce Eduardo's speech, WebMaker is an education tool. WebMaker is now localized in 12 languages. And we think it's important that it's localized in as many languages as we can, because, for example, kids, they don't speak English. Not every kid around the world speaks English. They need these tools in their own languages. And the teaching kits also, because if the interface is in their own language, but the teaching kits are in English, it's not so nice. Okay. If you have questions on this part, please ask them at the end of Eduardo's speech. Thank you.
Screens. Some technical problems.
Detect screen?
No detect. Yes. Oh, it's not detecting.
No, not this one. Cancel.
But not detecting.
Okay, that's the duplicate screen.
Duplicate. Yes.
Is it? No, I think you're on your own computer. No.
Oops.
No.
I don't know why it doesn't work. Wait a minute.
No, just... don't you have something to detect screens?
Yeah. What's that? I speak without slide.
Okay. start your speech?
Yes. Try. Hi everyone. I have some technical problems, but I will speak without slide now. Then the Mosedu I talk about the Mosedu project. This project born in to Mozilla Hispano some 2 years ago, and is basically this project is about to learn the children's and adolescents or adults to correctly use in the internet, the dangers in the internet, etc., and to conscientiate and involucrate the people before to use WebMaker, and then our events is in some colleges, some college principal in schools, and the principal questions is for the children's to how to make the code and the internet, and particularly our preoccupation is the privacy. Privacy principally in, for example, the children that use Facebook and some have a bullying to prepare the children for adapt him to not be a victim. I forget some words, and then if were my presentations, I can't show the image for our events in Paraguay, and 3 months ago was our first event in Brazil. I don't know. So my slate doesn't work. See, but thank you. Have any questions for Mosedu or WebMaker?
Maybe you have questions about their experiences, because both of them are really working on education through Mosedu, through WebMaker. And really, it's unfortunate for Eduardo not having his slides, because it's a deeply and truly experience that he's knowing in his country, and what he's doing is just astonishing. So I'm sorry for you not seeing that, but I really deeply encourage you to see them after the slot if you have some questions, because they have a lot of things to bring you and to teach you around education in code. Do you have questions? Yes?